Hello kids, I am Miss Vanita Diora. Today I welcome you all to watch the video of class 3. We are going to start with lesson number 14, the boy and the drum. So let's begin. So here is lesson number 14, the boy and the drum. And the get start activity is there. You have to draw your favorite musical instrument here. Your subject teacher will guide you. I have drawn mine. You can draw yours also. Now it's a story about a boy who had asked his mother to get a drum for him. And what happened next? Let us read the lesson. Here are characters narrated, children. The narrator is there. A boy is there. Mother, old man, potter's wife, washerman, washerman's wife, man, bridegroom and bridegroom's father. Bridegroom means Dulha. Now, as I told you, it's a form of a drama, dramatized, a script written in the form of a script. You can enact this as a role play also, children. So, a countryside. In a countryside, a woman is standing outside a small hut. Her son is seen nearby playing. You can see the picture. A woman is standing and his son is playing. Narrator says, once there was a poor woman. She worked hard as a gardener. She had a little son who was bright and cheerful. One day, after a hard day's work, she was going to the market. Mother said, what can I get for you from the market, little one? Boy said, a drum, mother. I would love to have a drum to play with. Narrator says, the mother knew she would never have enough money to buy a drum for her son. While returning home, she felt sad that she would have to face him empty-handed. So when she saw a nice wood on the road, she bought it home and gave it to her son. Son said, such a nice piece of wood. Thank you, mother. The boy did not know what to do with the piece of wood, but he was happy and carried it with him when he went out to play. So in the first scene, children, there's a conversation between a mother and a boy. When the mother is going to the market, she is asking his son, what do you want from the market? So the boy said, I want a drum. While returning from the market, she did not have enough money. So when she saw a piece of wood on the roadside, she picked up and gave it to his son. But still his son was happy with the piece of wood. He was not sad that his mother did not brought a drum for him. He was happy and he was still playing with the log of wood. Second scene is about children. In the another part of the village, an old man is sitting next to a small path. Path means road. On the ground in front of him, in a small clay stove with a pot on it, there is a smoke all around and the old man is coughing. Stove. Here the word stove means chulha. You can see over here, clay stove, mittika chulha. With a pot on it and there was a smoke, it's cloudy, like it's a smoke which is out of the stove. Old man was coughing because he was feeling suffering breathing problem due to this smoke. On his way, the boy comes across an old man. The old man was trying to light his stove using some cow dung cakes. Cow dung cakes means उपले, गोबर के उपले जो बनाते हैं ना सुखाने के बाद, वो सूखने के बाद जो रेडी होते हैं वो, उससे चूल्हा जलाया जाता है गांव में. Unfortunately, the fire was not catching. Boy said, what is the matter, grandpa? Can I help you in any way? Old man said, coughing. Little one, I am trying to cook some food, but I am unable to start a fire. I need a piece of wood. The boy says, giving the piece of wood to the old man, here, grandpa, you can use my piece of wood to start your fire. So here, exactly, children, in the second scene, If you relate the first scene and the second, the boy was moving on the roadside playing with the piece of wood, and when he saw this old man had to lit the stove, he offered the piece of wood, and the old man even took it away. Then old man, "Oh, you are such a helpful boy. Thank you." The old man was touched by the boy's kindness. He lit a fire, made some bread, and gave a piece to the boy. Here the highlighted word is there, children, touched. You can see the meaning is given here. Touched means moved. Means he was feeling very happy. He was really touched. Means andar se wo gadgad ho gaya ki he is so helpful. Boy says, that looks like a lovely piece of bread. Thank you, Grandpa. The boy took the piece of bread and skipped along singing a song. Now, the third scene begins, children. In the another part of the village, a poor woman is sitting by the road with many pots behind her. The woman is holding a baby in her arms and the baby is crying. What happened next? Let us see. Then the boy walked on till he came upon a potter's wife. She had a baby in her arms. The baby was crying. The boy asked, "Dear lady, why is your daughter crying?" Potter's wife said sadly, "My little one is hungry, but there is nothing to eat in the house." Boy said, "Do not worry, dear lady. Here, feed this piece of bread to your baby." Potter's wife said, "Oh, bless you, son. Here, please take this pot in return for your kindness." She gives the boy a pot. Boy said, "Such a beautiful pot. Thank you, lady." Narrator says, the boy was so happy to receive the pot that he skipped along humming a song. Humming a song means singing a song. So, third scene over, children. Now the fourth scene begins. Fourth scene is nearby a river bank. One side, a washerman is quarreling with his wife. A broken pot lies in front of the washerman's wife. What happened then? Walking along, the boy reached the river bank. There he saw a washerman quarreling with his wife. Quarreling means fighting. Boy said, "Dear sir, what is the matter?" Washerman said, "I gave her a pot and she broke it. I needed to boil my clothes. Without the pot, my clothes will rot and my trade will suffer." Rot means go bad and trade means business. Suffer means effect. Okay. Then washerman's wife said, "I did not mean to do it. Please don't be angry." Washerman's wife was telling to washerman that "I did not do it. I did not do it purposely. It happened. Now how can I help?" Boy said, giving them the pot, "Please do not quarrel. You may take this pot and use it." Washerman and his wife happily together said, "Thank you, dear lad." Lad means a boy. Washerman said, "Please take this coat as a gesture of thanks." Gesture means token of love. He gives the boy a lovely coat. Boy says, "Wow, such a lovely coat. Thank you, sir." The boy walked on admiring the grand coat. Admiring means looking at the coat presented by the washerman, singing a funny song. Presented means children, gifted here. So the boy was happy when he gave the pot to the washerman and his wife. They in return gave the boy a lovely grand coat. In the next scene, children, that is the fifth scene, is near a bridge. A man is standing on the bridge shivering. Shivering means tharatharata hai, thandi mein jaise winters mein we feel many a time. Shiver, right? Like that. He does not have a shirt on. A horse stands beside him. Narrator says, skipping along, the boy came to a bridge. There he saw a man shivering in the cold and moaning in pain. He was not even wearing a shirt. You can see this scene. A man is sitting near a river without a shirt. And he was literally shivering due to cold. Sir, man says, shivering, I was riding my horse to the city. A crowd of thieves beat me up and took my purse. They took everything, even my shirt. So what incident happened with the man? When he was riding his horse to the city, thieves attacked on him. Thieves beat this man, took away his purse and his shirt. And so he was sitting without a shirt. Children, here are the word meanings given. Gesture means sign. Admiring means looking at something with pleasure. Presented means gifted. And shivering means trembling, tharthrana. Boy says, please help you keep warm. Man says, touched by this boy's kindness. So nice of you, dear boy. Here, please take my horse in return. Boy said, wow, such a fine horse. Thank you, sir. The boy led the horse along happily, singing a song. The boy led the horse, and after that, there is a sixth scene. What happened? Another part of a village, a wedding procession with musicians and guests is gathered under a tree. All of them look sad. As he was walking along, the boy came upon a big wedding party. But the bridegroom and musicians had long faces, means sad faces. Boy said, why do you look so sad? Bridegroom's father said sadly, we need a horse for the groom. The man who was supposed to bring it hasn't turned up and we are losing time. Means we are having shortage of time. Boy said, do not be sad. Here, please, take my horse. Bridegroom said, oh, so kind of you. Please tell me, what do you want in return? The boy looked around among the musicians and spotted the drummer holding a nice drum. Boy said, all I want is that fine little drum. The groom requested the drummer to hand the drum to the boy. Soon the boy had a nice drum to play with. He rushed home happily, playing with his new drum. He could not wait to tell his mother she had helped him to get his drum. He skipped and danced and sang his song. What was the song, children? Here is the poem or a song what he was singing. My piece of wood did a lot of good. I got me bread as food. My piece of bread lasted not, but gave me a lovely pot. My pot got me a lovely pot did help a needy man. I got me a big fine horse to ride. With that horse, I got a groom, his bride. So you see, it is simple indeed. A little bit of give and take will a lot of people happy make. What did you understood at the end? Kids, always be kind and helpful to others, because people who really needs your help, they are going to pray for you, and God will give you abundance of your good deeds. Here is the end of the story, children. So let us recall. First, the mother brought a piece of wood from the market and gave it to a boy. Then the boy helped the old man who was. In return, the piece of bread, he carried. On the way, he met a woman with a crying baby. He gave a piece of bread to that crying baby, and in return, he got a pot. The pot he gave to the washerman couple who was fighting, right? In return, the washerman gave him a coat, and that coat he gave to that shivering man. Then that man gave him a horse. And further, he gave the horse to the bridegroom, and the bridegroom wanted to help this boy by giving some gift, and he asked for a drum. So from first to end, he helped so many people and got the drum finally. So his wish was fulfilled. At last, children, if you have not understood any of the terms or vocabulary items, your subject teacher will help you. Thank you.